classical here, but I really want to have a good discussion period. I'm guessing this will be a controversial topic, we'll see. Is semantic media wiki overly complicated? In most setups, it has, at heart it's a table structure. Most cases people are using MySQL, which in turn represents a triple store, all the properties and so forth. And really that in turn is representing a table structure, because most of the time people are storing structured data using templates. Everything is well organized. There are few or no free-form properties being used. So yes, I would say most of the time it is more complicated than it used to be. That was sort of the kernel that got me started thinking about whether there could be another approach. And that's how Cargo came about. It's a MediaWiki extension that I created, and it's mostly written by me, although other people have contributed. It was first released in January, so it's been 9 months. It does storage and querying data, which is basically the description of semantic MediaWiki. And it's actually, it turned out to be fairly easy to make an alternative, not just to semantic MediaWiki, but to the in main SMW ecosystem, meaning also semantic result formats, semantic maps, semantic drill downs, semantic compound queries, internal objects. You don't need to worry about a semantic internal object. That's essentially obsolete at this point. But then also all the data values extensions, all the library extensions that semantic MediaWiki uses that get installed behind the scenes. So it's actually 15 extensions in all that Cargo can replace. And here's the it's fully documented. It has a whole page on MediaWiki.org with a lot of links and sections. So you can see all the details. How does it work? It uses a table structure, not a graph structure. We're talking about tables, virtual tables of data. This stores it in actual tables. So for each info box template, and those usually correspond to one category, a separate database table is created on the fly by the software. And then each call to a template just essentially adds one row to that, the table for that overall template. And then the query language can become very simple because you have SQL. I'm guessing most people here have heard of SQL. It's a query language for standard relational databases. So unlike with Semantic MediaWiki, where there's a whole framework set up for this custom query language, here it's very much it's a safe wrapper. I have to stress that, but it's just a wrapper around SQL. There are four main parser functions. Really, the three top ones are really the important ones. There's one that lets you declare a table. There's one that lets you store one row into a table. There's the Cargo query, which is the most like SMW's ask, which is essentially also a SQL select statement. And then finally, there's Cargo compound query, which is like a semantic compound query. So here, this is a little hard to see, but if you have a table, a template called country representing countries, in the no include part, you have the declaration, because it just applies to the template itself. In the include only part, the part that gets called in every page, you would have Cargo store, which creates one row of this table. And that's just a little more technical stuff. Here's a sample query. This is what it looks like if you know SQL. All of these parameters, each one corresponds basically to a clause of an SQL statement. So this is a basic one that will just show a table of two columns. And here's a more complicated one involving a join. If you know SQL, you can probably figure out what's going on here. And then there's a format parameter, much like MediaWiki has. The whole thing is very much openly based syntax of semantic MediaWiki. What are the query formats? It's basically all the same ones that Semantic MediaWiki has. It was much easier to implement them the second time. In case you want a little demonstration, here's a my site DiscourseDB is now running, DiscourseDB.org is now running on Cargo. You couldn't really tell that this is not Semantic MediaWiki. It looks the same. Bulleted list, here's a JavaScript dynamic tables thing. Calendar, no links to that one, where's the timeline thing? At the bottom of this, I should have checked. There's a timeline, there it is. Maps, Google Maps and Open Layers, and this was just recently added, not by me actually. Exhibit, this is something that Semantic MediaWiki used to have, now it has something called Filter. But it is essentially the same thing. This is you can do instantaneous filtering. And Exhibit is a cool JavaScript based filtering thing. So the majority, maybe 80%, and the most important formats that the Semantic MediaWiki ecosystem provides are now also provided by Cargo. So why use it? Number one is that it's easier to install. It's just one extension instead of 15, which means you don't necessarily need Composer, Semantic Bundle, you've heard of those. It's easier to understand. I think this is a more subjective thing, but people are generally more familiar with table structures from working with spreadsheets, and in some cases databases, than graph structures. And just as far as what's in the wiki, the fact that everything is in the template as opposed to a template and a whole bunch of properties makes it simpler to understand in theory. And similarly, this one is very much tied in. It's easier to set up the data structures. If each template has 10 or more properties, then the property pages will very quickly overwhelm your entire data structure and becomes kind of a chore to maintain everything. There's also no sub-objects, if you know about those, because all data is stored the same way. It's all just rows in a table, so it doesn't matter whether a page has one call to a template or many. It's all going to be stored and queried the same way. This one is more minor, but you don't need to set up drill down filters. Oh, I was going to show the drill down thing. If you use semantic drill down, the fact that there's something that essentially looks the same, and it is here. The fact that the template knows about its own structure means that the system can do this sort of thing automatically, and you don't have to specify, oh, for this category, I want to filter on these things, because the system can basically know that already, knows what you can filter on. It's easier to set up queries if you know SQL. It's easier because it's built around SQL. And you don't have to learn a whole other syntax. It's more powerful querying, I think. Here are three examples of queries that you can do in Cargo, but you can't in SMW unless you do some one hack or another. The first is probably the most popular one that gets asked about. In Semantic MediaWiki, you can't display join cordially. For each city, I want to show the flag of its country. In Cargo, it's just a matter of a SQL type join. Similarly, getting all pages with a blank value for a field is easy to do. And just any sort of complex combination and or and not, you can do with a bunch of parentheses as you would in SQL. Faster querying. I only ran one test. There's a period of time when on my wiki, I had everything stored in both SMW and Cargo, so I ran a test, and the Cargo query was 50% faster. I ran 2/3 of the time. It's not a very scientific test, but it makes sense that it would be faster because you're going directly to the tables instead of using this you know, wrapper data structure. There's easier querying from outside the wiki if you have some sort of software that can go into a database and do analysis, or you want to do extra querying. With Instamate VDWiki, you have to use the API, and it's a little bit of a pain because there's a set query limit, so if there's more data than that, you need to run it more times. In Cargo, you can do that. Cargo has an API, but you can also just go to the database tables. They basically look like what you expect them to look like. It's just, you know, just all the data. It's just, you know, rows and columns. In my opinion, it's easier to develop and maintain software. Here's just some very rough estimates of, or listings of the amount of PHP code, not counting all the third-party libraries. Cargo's only 10,000 lines of code, which is not really a testament to anything, but the fact that it makes use of SQL directly, so there's just a lot of stuff it doesn't even need to worry about. Just by virtue of that, it's easier to do further development on. In the interest of what?
Seven.
Okay, great. In the interest of fairness, there are advantages of Semantic Media Wiki over Cargo. The most basic one, I guess, is that you can store arbitrary data. You can put in freeform properties, and some people do that. So you can't do that. You can do it in Cargo, but it would be a total hack. Hierarchical querying of categories, which that is a cool feature of Semantic Media Wiki. You can query in a category called World Leaders, and subcategories of that will also show up in the results. That you can't do that within Cargo. You have to do a join. Every time. Querying of page metadata, like the date a page is created and so forth, you can't do in Cargo, but this may be coming. It's certainly possible within the existing system to have an extra table that holds that kind of metadata. RDF storage and export also can't be done. There's no reason why they can't get added. That functionality doesn't. And then the semantic watch list, but actually this should be semantic anything that, we had the talk earlier today about the semantic meta tags and all those other, you know, there's a whole bunch of semantic extensions, so how big an issue this is depends on how much you use those, smaller extensions. I think semantic watch list is the big one that whose functionality doesn't exist. It would be great to have a notification system that works. If neither SMW nor Cargo is installed, but there's no such thing yet, unfortunately. Am I destroying this community? I don't think so. This is serious. I mean, semantic community is more than properties and ask queries. First of all, just from a technical level, it's an entire text-based approach to data that is still amazingly unique. As far as I know, there's no software, proprietary or open source, that has this kind of flexible text-based approach to data storage that makes modifying the data and the data structures so easy to do. And that, of course, is the same regardless of what you use as the back-end system. We're also the energy and the voice of Enterprise Media Wiki, in my opinion. Some talks, the Media Wiki stakeholders group is a great example. There's a very big overlap between that and some Media Wiki users, and that's not a coincidence. None of that will change even if everyone switches to Cargo. Of course, not everyone's going to switch, but even if there's a sizable switch, all of that non-technical, outside of the wiki stuff is going to stay the same. And that really is, I think, the heart of the community, not the specific syntax being used to run queries. What about SMWCon? I hope it will continue, maybe with a different name, maybe with a broader focus. That's the question that's the not up to me, but it's a community decision, but I just wanted to throw that out there. Questions, comments, complaints? Yes.
As you know, Jaren, I was from the beginning I have been experimenting with cargo. And I have one wiki that runs entirely on cargo. But, I think you're talking about an alternative and switching. But I think at least for the short term, the real interest is if you have a benefit from one of these advantages of cargo, just install it next to Semantic Media Wiki and benefit from those. For example, if you have integration with other systems, and it's very important to have an easy interface, because the other system likes to talk to a simple SQL database, then cargo certainly is correct.
Yeah, I really should have included the slide about that. There's no reason why you can't run the two and have the two both
starting. Yeah, it means that you don't have the advantage of easy install, etc.
Right.
But you can solve some difficult problems by installing cargo as well.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. Yes.
Yeah, it often happens that a data system has some confusion and blessing between the two set of aspects, the underlying data and the user interface in that picture. And when it happens, it's important to recognize that the system has some confusion and offer this new solution. And that's usually one of three things. One is you say, forget the underlying data, it's pure interface, and nothing happens like it's an interface. Another solution is ideally, not yet reached the body true condition, but where you can have pure data on one side and pure interface that is very different. It can also be used to replace one confusion with another. And hopefully what you do is less confusion if you aim for it. So I don't think anyone's going to help with the first solution. Have you aimed for anything since you see yourself as purely interface, or maybe not clean with the condition between these two, or maybe a substitution that's somewhat less confusing, but not perfect?
I'm really not sure if I understand the question. I mean, I don't know. I think this is cleaner. I think it's a cleaner solution, if that's what you mean.
Well, what I see a lot of iterations is that there's data about what's really needed to make the user, and there's data that's needed to run the underlying user. That is and what you saw was there's a lot of switching between table and graph that happens on the day, especially if you look into our established in Snap Graph, where you got to look at it.
Sure.
And what I see from Cargo is you sit here into the table and SQL.
That's right.
You see that as the underlying graph that's being used to more important as you stick into the interface components.
Yeah. Absolutely. I mean, really, the template. We talk about templates, but really, we could call this template media wiki con. Really, that's a horrible name, but so much of what we do is based around the fact that the templates exist and let us create this structure, and that's really what it's about. And I think cargo is a good approximation of a real data source, which is these template calls. It is. I do view it as table-based, because the people use that structure. I mean, that's how the data is stored for the most part.
And the alternative, the antithesis of cargo is people. We have something like where some people have.
Sorry.